Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Heather Sells. Forecasters say the drenching rain is winding down in the Northeast, but the worst of the widespread flooding is yet to come. President Obama has signed an emergency declaration for Rhode Island, where floodwaters have reached historic levels. Charlene Israel has more.
The storm has soaked all corners of what is known as the Ocean State, pushing rivers over their banks, closing roads and schools. Police and fire officials went door to door to evacuate Rhode Islanders from their flooded homes.
Fire department couldn't get to because the apparatus was too low. We backed the truck up to the doors and we took about maybe 18 people out on Valley Street.
Crews worked overnight to stack sandbags. Officials say it's the worst flooding in the state in 100 years, and it's expected to continue.
We're in an unprecedented area right now in terms of the impact of the amount of water that we are absorbing and the flooding.
The storm is the second to drench the East Coast in less than a month. Flood warnings are in effect from New York City to Boston. In Massachusetts, the governor declared a state of emergency as rivers rose toward flood stage.
We're expecting flood waters to rise very quickly, as I've said before, so my message to the public is the same. Exercise extreme caution.
Forecasters say the storm made this the wettest March on record in many places, making for a long and expensive recovery for states already hit hard by the recession. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
President Obama is expected to announce today he will allow drilling 50 miles off Virginia's shoreline. Virginia Governor Bob McDonnell has already approved offshore drilling. He did it earlier this month. The new Obama policy reverses a more than 20-year-old ban on offshore drilling except in the Gulf of Mexico. Obama's plan will also allow seismic exploration for oil and gas off the coast from Delaware all the way to Florida. The Virginia drilling represents a change from the president's campaign trail promises.
The Obama administration now includes a controversial lesbian law professor who says sexual liberty is more important than religious liberty. Using recess appointments to fill 15 positions, President Obama named Hy Feldblum to the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. The EEOC focuses on discrimination in the workplace, including potential discrimination against sexual minorities. We shared some of Feldblum's controversial statements shortly after her nomination several months ago. Take a listen.
Gay sex is morally good. Now, you may think that might be a little crazy to go out there and saying gay sex is good. But think a second. Society definitely believes that heterosexual sex is good. So here's my bottom line. There is a war that needs to be fought. And it's not a war overseas where we're killing people in the name of liberating them. It is a war right here at home where we need to convince people that morality demands full equality for gay people.
Several organizations have called Feldblum's appointment dangerous for religious freedoms, especially in light of statements like this. Sexual liberty should win in most cases. There can be a conflict between religious liberty and sexual liberty, but in almost all cases, the sexual liberty should win because that's the only way that the dignity of gay people can be affirmed in any realistic manner. I'm having a hard time coming up with any case in which religious liberty should win.
For the second time in a week, President Obama has signed health care legislation into law. This follow-up measure includes the so-called fixes added by House Democrats, including big adjustments to the way millions of college students apply for and pay back student loans. The president took his pitch to a community college. As Jennifer Wishon reports, some are worried how this will affect not only students, but also jobs across the country.
The first couple received a first-class education and knows firsthand what it's like to be overwhelmed by tuition bills.
Michelle and I had big debts coming out of school.
Perhaps that's why the president is overseeing the largest rewrite of federal college aid programs in 40 years. Starting in 2014, the federal government, not private banks, will become the primary lender to college students. The president calls it cutting out the middleman. Banks no longer get fees to facilitate federal loans, saving $68 billion.
Those are billions of dollars that could have been spent helping more of our students attend and complete college, that could have been spent advancing the dreams of our children.
The average American student graduates more than $23,000 in debt. About half of students receive federal student aid. 8.5 million of them receive Pell Grants.
Not only are we going to offer over 800,000 additional Pell awards over the next 10 years, we're also going to raise the amount they're worth to almost $6,000 so that inflation does not erode the value of your grant.
But questions remain.
People have a lot of opinions about it.
Margaret Spelling served as Secretary of Education under President George W. Bush. She tells CBN News she's skeptical of giving students less financial choice. And opponents argue pulling billions of dollars out of the banking industry will slash thousands of jobs.
This is an industry, you know, a consumer lending product that has thrived in the private sector. It's been good for students. It's been good for job creation. I wonder about the ability for the U.S. Department of Education to be the lender for literally millions of students.
President Obama is signaling more changes are on the way. This fall, Vice President Biden will host a community college summit to generate ideas and help the president reach his goal for America to graduate more students than any other nation by the year 2020. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Thanks, Jennifer. The U.S. government will soon begin selling its shares in Citigroup. The move could result in the Treasury Department profiting $7.5 billion. The government received a large share in Citigroup after giving it $25 billion during the credit crisis in 2008. Citigroup stock is now on the rise, so the U.S. plans to sell its shares and make a profit.
Suicide bombings have rocked Russia for the second time this week. Police pulled over a suspicious-looking car this time, and the driver detonated explosives. Then, as police officers and residents gathered at the scene, there was a second blast. These bombings happened in the southern province of Dagestan, and they come just 2 days after twin suicide bombings tore through the Moscow subway and killed 39 people. Today's blast killed at least 12 people, including two police officers.
French President Nicolas Sarkozy has joined President Obama in calling for harsher sanctions against Iran. In a joint press conference Tuesday at the White House, they struck an urgent tone in the need for the UN to act against the regime's quest for nuclear weapons.
So I'm not interested in waiting months for a sanctions regime to be in place. I'm interested in seeing that regime in place in weeks. And we are working diligently with our international partners.
Le temps est venu.
The time to make a decision has arrived. Iran cannot continue on this mad race. Therefore, we will provide all our support in order to obtain the hardest sanctions within the Security Council.
Meantime, ABC News is reporting that an Iranian nuclear scientist missing since last year has actually defected to the U.S., and he is providing information about Iran's nuclear program. Recently, CBN's George Thomas reported on the disappearance of that very same scientist and the revelations that followed soon after.
Then in June 2009, Shahram Amiri, another scientist working for Iran's nuclear agency, went missing while on a pilgrimage to Saudi Arabia. Iran accuses the Saudis of kidnapping and turning him over to the United States. It was shortly after Amiri's disappearance that the U.S. became aware of a secret nuclear facility near the Iranian city of Qom. Alex Vatakan is an Iranian specialist working for the Jane's intelligence.
Could it be a coincidence? Maybe not. But the fact is, these defections are of huge value to the Western intelligence community.
That report took a closer look at the disappearance and deaths of several Iranian nuclear scientists in recent months. You can see that full story on our website at cbnnews.com.
City officials in Rancho Cucamonga, California, are dropping their challenge to a home Bible study group. The city had demanded that Shiloh Tabernacle Church obtain a permit for its weekly meetings because they said the gathering constituted a home church. About 60 people attend the Friday night meetings at the pastor's house. The city withdrew its demand after meeting with the pastor and determining the meetings are simply a Bible study. Brad Dacus of the Pacific Justice Institute says it is still wrong for the city to require permits for home churches.
Pastor John Piper is taking a leave from his influential ministry. He told his congregation at Bethlehem Baptist Church in Minneapolis he needs a reality check from the Holy Spirit because of what he calls prideful sipping from the poisonous cup of international fame and notoriety. That means no preaching, book writing, or blogging for 8 months. Piper also said this time will be used to work on his marriage with his wife of 41 years, Noelle. He says they are rock solid in commitment to each other and that there is no whiff of unfaithfulness on either side, but that the precious garden of his home needs tending. You can read Piper's entire letter about his decision at cbnnews.com.
The Reverend Billy Graham apparently would like to get back in the pulpit. The 91-year-old evangelist has told his family that he'd like to preach one more time. He told his daughter, Ann Graham Lotz, saying that he's praying for that opportunity. Lotz says her dad has trouble hearing, seeing, and walking, but is not yet ready to join his wife, Ruth, who died in 2007.
More Americans are going fishing these days. That is according to a report commissioned by the Outdoor Foundation. The report found the peaceful pastime saw an increase of about 630,000 new anglers last year. That ended a decade of decline in fishing, especially among young people. The Outdoor Foundation reports almost 41 million Americans fish.
Coming up, a controversial British bill moves forward. Will it force churches to hold same-sex partnerships?
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to burn.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord, God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to you.
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only
$24.99.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right, you get 50 praise and worship songs for just $9.99. Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Some students at Trinity University in San Antonio want their college to drop a Christian reference from their diplomas. Members of a campus diversity group says the words Our Lord do not respect the diversity of religions on campus. That group's leader is a Muslim. The university trustees are expected to consider that request in May. Trinity was founded by Presbyterians in 1869.
The House of Lords in Great Britain is allowing civil partnership ceremonies in churches. Church leaders had voiced concerns that they could face prosecution for refusing to provide these services for same-sex couples. But the British government said religious organizations will not be forced to act against their beliefs. Peter Wooding has more from London.
The controversial Equality Bill was passed in the House of Lords this week, which now allows same-sex civil partnerships to take place in churches across the UK. Senior church leaders had voiced concerns this new legislation could result in them facing costly legal action if they refused to marry same-sex couples. However, last-minute amendments now include provisions for denominations such as the Church of England to be able to prevent ministers going against church policy and registering civil partnerships in a church.
Here at the Evangelical Alliance, which represents thousands of churches across the UK, they were calling on the government to this week guarantee that churches will be free to choose whether or not to hold civil partnerships without fear of future anti-discrimination.
Dr. Don Horrocks, head of public affairs for the Evangelical Alliance, says he's relieved the government has been listening to their concerns.
Baroness Royal, who is leader of the House of Lords and who is in charge of the Equality Bill in the House of Lords, he went out of her way to make it clear that it was not possible for ministers of religion to be the subject of anti-discrimination claims for refusing to carry out a civil partnership on their premises.
So does Horrocks believe independent churches could still be sued for refusing to take up the new legal powers to register civil partnerships?
There is a consensus amongst legal advisers that there is a very, very strong defence and that such a claim is most unlikely to be successful.
But Director of Religion and Society think tank Ecclesia, Jonathan Bartley, has given a warm welcome to the new legislation.
At its heart, this is really an issue of religious liberty. It's about saying, yes, there are a diverse range of Christian views on this issue, but if a Christian or another religious person comes forward and says, actually, I believe according to my faith and my conscience that a civil partnership is the way that God is leading me, then they shouldn't be prohibited by law from doing that on a Christian basis.
Bartley says legal changes need to go much further to respond to the social diversity of relationships.
You should be able to have religious ceremonies celebrating your relationship, your marriage, your commitment as a Christian, your covenant for life with the other person. And then you should be able to go to the state and say, and I want to register this in law, and have that as a separate arrangement. Now, as the situation stands, because of the established Church of England, you can't have that in this country. When you get married in a church, it's also a legal act, and the two are run together. We're saying it's time to actually separate out the two.
However, as groups like Ecclesia welcome this new legislation, many Christians remain deeply concerned not only at the legal implications, but also at the continuing erosion of the institution of marriage. Peter Wooding for CBN News, London, England.
Up next, a church group that meets in strip clubs. You'll meet the pastor behind the plan right after this.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
So what happens when Christians get out of their comfort zones and start serving others?
Well, that is what's going on in San Diego, where members of the Rock Church are taking part in the Do Something Challenge. And as Wendy Griffith reports, it's changing their community.
San Diego is one of the most beautiful cities in America. The refreshing ocean breeze and sunshine draw tourists from around the world. But at night, it's a different world. Believe it or not, this is where a few members of San Diego's The Rock Church hang out. They're known as JC's Girls, and they minister to the women in the strip clubs.
We actually go into the clubs and bring the girls gifts, and this is an example of one of our gifts. Give them a pink Bible and a candle, some lip gloss, and a love letter that just really lets them know that God loves them.
Sherry, how many girls have you rescued from the stripper clubs here in San Diego?
Me? None. God? Several. He is doing things beyond our comprehension. For instance, there's one club we weren't even allowed to get into, but we left the gifts. And 2 months later, a girl shows up at our Bible study, and she ended up getting saved that Sunday at church and has been a part of the ministry.
And then there's the homeless ministry. About 20 to 30 members of The Rock come out every Saturday to minister to those who've fallen on hard times.
We bring the church to the homeless. So a lot of times they usually come towards us, and we have just like a regular church service.
Yeah.
And today, since it was really pouring down rain, a lot of people are mainly under bridges like this. Whatever resources we have for today, water, coffee, food, we ended up just packing up our stuff and bringing it out here.
That creates the tension.
Pastor Miles McPherson, a former NFL player with the San Diego Chargers, started the Do Something Charge at the Rock Church and recently wrote a book about it.
So your book is really about making people uncomfortable who are just sitting in the pews.
Jesus said in John 14:12 that if we believed him, the things he did, we would do and even greater works. People don't believe that. So I fed 5,000, you may be able to feed 10. And so if we believe in him, we are supposed to do something, go preach the gospel, go be a witness, go make disciples. Those are all verbs. And so sitting in church, even though that's a verb, that's not included. That's only part of what he's saying.
Among the church's more than 100 outreaches is a ministry called Cancer Care, where volunteers help people going through the trauma of cancer with a wide range of services, including prayer.
Give her peace, Lord. Things like housekeeping, taking care of the children while you're recovering, more support group services that are Christ-based. People needed meals when they couldn't cook for themselves.
In 2009, Rock Church members gave the city of San Diego more than 166,000 hours of community service as part of their Do Something campaign. That equated into about $2.6 million for the city.
So we cleaned up parks, we painted park benches and tables, we planted trees, we painted rec centers, we mentored kids. But our church went out and every week, every day, did something on behalf of our city.
Now, Pastor McPherson is challenging churches across the country to do the same in their own cities.
Well, Jesus is a very practical God. He comes into our life and he addresses very practical needs in our lives. So why shouldn't we address practical needs in the city's lives?
But how do you know which ministry is right for you? For many people, it's born out of their own experiences. Michelle Casa learned sign language because her best friend's son was deaf. Now she runs a foster home for hearing impaired children and even adopted a deaf child.
I just had a gift for the language, picked it up very quickly, fell in love with the deaf world, the deaf people, and the culture, and eventually started interpreting at church.
McPherson says as God's children, if we don't go, who will? And who will reach people like Mindy, a former stripper who cried out to God one night in the club for a sign from heaven?
About 5 minutes later, JC's girls walked into the club, and that was the answer to my prayer.
And what did they do?
Told me that God loves me. I was shocked. First of all, you don't usually associate church women with strip clubs. And I needed to hear that because the industry will destroy you.
Today, Mindy volunteers with the JC's Girls to help other women find their way out of the strip clubs and the simple truth that God loves them. McPherson says that's what the Do Something campaign is really all about.
Wendy Griffith, CBN News, San Diego.
What a contrast, the beautiful skyline and the sin.
Yeah, absolutely. Lots of work to be done. It's a good thing that they are actually doing something to make a difference out there.
Yeah, great example.
Indeed. Stay with us. We're coming right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new do's. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new. Or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt. But Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With a step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Well, finally today, a tiny town in Washington State has been put on the auction block.
But not everyone's on board.
Locals aren't real thrilled about it.
Why?
I think they think I have some audacity to claim to own the whole town.
Meet Daphne Fletcher. She's single-handedly selling the town of Wakanda, and she's selling it on eBay. The most current bid is a reasonable $370,000. It is much to the chagrin of those who own farms just outside the center of town.
I do claim to own the center of town and all of the businesses, and I think the businesses commune establishes a community. We have a restaurant and a gas station and a store and a post office. That's what I'm claiming to sell. It was a Wild West little mining town about 100 years ago. At one time, there was like 1,000 people in this town, and there was like several hotels. When the gold busted, the people kind of left.
Own a post office too. So if you want to own an old mining town, it is not too late. There are still about 2 days left in that auction.
And that is all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories you've seen here at cbnnews.com.
And stay up to date with us through Facebook and Twitter. We'll see you right here again next time.
CBN presents Superbook for a new generation. Now, reimagined from the classic CBN cartoon, a new series featuring amazing Bible stories brought to life using state-of-the-art animation.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Your kids will love being entertained while they learn biblical values like courage, loyalty, humility, and faith as they join Chris, Joy, and Gizmo in their travels through time. In the first episode, A Giant Adventure, Chris and friends land in ancient Israel, where they meet David and witness his fierce battle against the giant Goliath.
You come to me with sword and spear, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of Hosts.
Your gift of $25 or more will help create future Superbook episodes. As our thank you, you'll receive a special edition DVD of the first episode and our brand new Superbook trading cards. Give your child the advantage of learning God's Word. Superbook, superpower to change your life.
Ready in the set?
Dr. Robertson in 3, 2...
On December 3rd, 2009, Pat Robertson entered the studio to update his landmark work, The Secret Kingdom, to help people live abundant lives amid today's challenges.
I want to talk to you today about The Secret Kingdom. What is The Secret Kingdom?
The Secret Kingdom, Volume 1, available now.